So do you know where your garbage goes? Chances are, if you live in Spokane County, it comes here. Welcome to the City of Spokane's Waste Energy Facility, and thank you for joining me on the tour today. A lot of people don't realize that Spokane has the only waste energy facility in the entire state, and it's been here since 1991. Before that, all of our garbage was buried in five landfills. And in Spokane County, we just happen to live on top of our sole source of drinking water, an aquifer. So burying garbage on top of that drinking water wasn't the best way of managing solid waste. So we needed another option, and waste energy was the choice. It was very controversial when it was built, and there are still questions about how it operates today. That's why we like to have tours. Today you're going to learn how we can process up to 800 tons of municipal solid waste by burning it in two boilers. How we take the heat from burning that garbage to generate steam and then also make electricity for up to 13,000 homes. We'll also talk about what we do with the ash that comes out, as well as how we clean the air before it goes out our stack. So we do have a lot to cover on the tour today, so grab a hard hat and let's begin. The waste energy plant is located right next to the airport off of Interstate 90's Geiger Boulevard exit. The stack is 170 feet tall and towers over the entire property. As residents come in, they have an option of stopping at a recycle drop-off area where they can drop off recyclables as well as household hazardous waste. As we go up to the tipping floor, or where people drop off the trash, we're going to pass by a residential scale house. There, our scale house operators weigh people in and out and then collect the fees based on what's left behind. So we do have a bit of a walk up there. Follow me. Now in the tipping floor. And the tipping floor is just where people throw garbage out on the ground to be disposed of. So on the tipping floor, we have two sections. Behind us is a place where people can bring yard waste to us. That gets reloaded and taken to a commercial composting facility. We also have a place for non-burnables and large appliances. So that material might get sent directly to a landfill, or if it's scrap metal, like an appliance, we sell it to be recycled. The garbage on this side of the building is just tossed out by residents. And on the other side of the building, the truck's bringing our trash from two other transfer stations, as well as it's picking up at the curbside. That's where they offload. Eventually, our heavy equipment operators use front-end loaders to push all that trash back into a pit that's behind me. That pit is 40 feet deep. And once that trash is there, we look at it as a fuel source. We have a crane operator that sits in a room up on the side of the wall, and he runs the claw, or what we call a grapple. But it's his job to mix that garbage up, make sure it's fluffy and it's dry, and then he feeds it into the feed hopper to our two boilers. And those are located on each side of the room up there. Now, we only accept garbage here until 5 o'clock every day, but we have to burn it all night long to make room for the garbage that comes in tomorrow. So the next part of the facility that we'll look at runs 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. So we're gonna go on inside. Welcome to the control room, or the brains of the operation. Here we can monitor up to 1,400 points of information happening throughout the plant. And that is done by our plant operator. You can see that he has video monitors as well as data screens to keep track of everything and make adjustments in real time. Things that he's monitoring are temperatures in the boilers, steam pressure, as well as how much electricity we generate. We can generate up to 22 megawatts. We use 3 to 5 megawatts to run the plant itself, and then the extra we sell to Avista Utilities, which is usually enough for 13,000 homes. One of the most important things we monitor here is the air quality or the emissions or what comes out of our stack. It's very highly regulated by environmental agencies, and we always pride ourselves on running very well below those limits. Anything that happens in the plant that impacts air quality can be adjusted immediately. Now that information independently goes to our oversight agencies like the Department of Ecology, the Spokane Health District, and the Spokane Clean Air Agency. Next on our tour, we're going to go into our boiler rooms and see up close how we burn that garbage to make the energy. I'm standing next to one of our two boilers. Now, each boiler can burn up to 400 tons of trash every single day. The claw, if you remember, will pick up measured amounts of garbage, feed it into a feed hopper that's two stories above us. That garbage will be funneled down and then pushed out in measured amounts on the top floor of the boiler. Now, the boiler floor is at a slant and it has moving grates. So that garbage will slowly work its way down through several burning zones. It dries out, it catches fire, and then finished ash will drop off into a quench tank of water and the floor below us. Now, pollution begins inside each of the boilers. We use anhydrous ammonia that we spray into the gases inside the boiler to neutralize nitrogen oxides. We then pull the gases outside the boiler and inject charcoal or carbon, which kind of grabs onto the mercury and makes it easier for us to remove. All of those gases then go to what's called an acid scrubber, which is a tall cylinder on the other side of this wall. We use a lime slurry that we spray into that cylinder and then pull the gases through it, and that lime neutralizes the acid gases. Next, all of those gases go into what's called a baghouse, where the particulates are filtered out. So for every boiler, there are over 1,700 of these cylinders, which are a little bit longer, but they're wrapped with fabric and they have a vacuum that's pulling through the middle. So all the fine particulates, or what we call fly ash, is trapped against the cloth. Then we blow that off, that drops down, and we will mix our fly ash with bottom ash to go out and be treated. Now, fire needs oxygen to burn, right? So we get that air from the pit area. We have big fans that pull in that kind of dirty, smelly air, and we use that to blow into the boilers to get that high temperature. Because we want to take that temperature to make steam. So you'll notice the big pipes above us? That's bringing water into the walls of our boilers. And the boiler walls themselves are made up of water tubes. Each boiler can hold about 20,000 gallons of water. We heat that water up, make steam, and that steam is going to turn a turbine to generate our electricity. The next place we go will be our turbine room. And you're also going to see a dragon there, so keep your eyes open. This is the turbine room. And I told you we're going to see a dragon, didn't I? Well, you can't see the steam turn the turbine, but you can get an idea of how it works. At the tail of the dragon, a high-pressure steam pipe is bringing steam to turn the turbine at over 3,600 revolutions per minute. The generator is located on the other side of the dragon, making the electricity. The steam, after it turns the turbine, is going out the large pipe at the head of the dragon. Our next stop, we'll talk about where that steam is going and also where the electricity comes out. Now that we're outside the building, you can see that big pipe that's coming out the side. that's bringing the steam that's already turned the turbine out to be cooled. That pipe will take that steam over a bank of fans called an air-cooled condenser. Those fans will cool that steam back into water, and then we recirculate the water back to be made into steam again. You'll also see our switching yard. So the electricity that we generate here, and we don't use to run the plant itself, goes directly to the power grid over the overhead lines to those 13,000 homes. We're going to finish our tour on the other side of the building where we're going to talk about the ash. This is the last stop on the tour today. We're going to talk about the ash. The ash that leaves the boilers is 90% less in volume than the garbage that went in. So it will take up a lot less room when it does go to a landfill. We also treat it as it comes out the building with lime. And that lime binds the heavy metals to the ash and renders it inert. The ash then is taken to a warehouse where we use a grizzly separator and magnets, and we pull out ferrous metal. In fact, we can recover up to 25 tons worth of metal every day from the ash before it goes to the landfill, and that metal goes to be recycled. The ash is then loaded into small containers and taken to the Roosevelt landfill in Klickitat County. There in the landfill, it does take up a lot less room than regular garbage. It's not going to leak anything out into the ground, nor does it generate methane gas, which is a powerful greenhouse gas emission. And you'll never see smoke coming out of our stack. If anything, you might see a vapor plume as that warm air that leaves the boilers hits the colder air outside. So that's pretty much how we work here. Garbage comes in, ash and electricity come out. So thank you for joining me on the tour today. And please remember, there is no good way of dealing with garbage except not to make it in the first place. All right, thanks everyone. Goodbye.